Hey guys, see for Jason. BJJ does not work for self-defense in modern America. There, I said it. I know I'm going to catch some flack for this, I know, but hear me out. Multiple opponents changes the equation, absolutely changes the equation. So you need a self-defense system that is consistent with reality, because reality has a basic rule: get real or get gone. That's it. Now, certain fields you can be a little bit more unrealistic, a bit more irrational than in others, right? Like politics. Politicians are irrational all the time, and they get away with it to an extent. Firemen, police officers, scuba divers, that kind of thing. Pilots, they've got to be a lot more realistic. So here, I'd say that if a fight starts in modern America, you're likely to see multiple opponents. And if you're doing BJJ and you're confused, you're not doing BJJ and you think it's a fantastic discipline and you love it, and you're throwing all your heart, your passion to it, and you're trying to get the next belt, you're trying to win a medal at the next tournament, that's great. But if you think you're going to do that in a multiple opponent scenario, or you're just hoping, well, if there is a fight, it won't be multiple opponents, you've got a problem, and maybe a big one, because America, if you haven't been noticing, is spiraling downhill fast. It's a book of judges. When everyone does what's right in their own eyes, things go badly. And then the sequel to Book of Judges, the secular sequel, Lord of the Flies, you're not looking at life realistically. It's going to get worse. When I was a kid, back in the 1850s, and I was sparring with Abe Lincoln and my buddies. I'm not that old, but things have changed a lot since I was a kid. Because when I was a kid, we had a lot of fights in my neighborhood, and nobody ever jumped in. It was always a case where if one guy started getting worked over, even that guy's enemies would still pull their buddy off, because nobody should get their head bashed in for that. You lost the fight, that's it. That's not the case anymore. I'll be putting some stuff on the screen here. I'm not showing the video because YouTube gets all bent out of shape. Our tech overlords, they get all bent out of shape. It's violent content. So you can follow some of those stories if you want to see videos of them. But I'm sure you've seen them yourself, multiple opponent fights. There's one in Florida. Four or five guys, they slam his kid on his head and he gets a fractured skull, and that's not fun, right? That's not fun. And that's multiple opponents. I'll show you several. A dad was at a grocery store, Kroger in Ohio, and these teenage guys, I mean, these are big grown men in teenage minds, go in there and they just beat the crap out of this guy. And how'd that work out? And I could go on and on and on with this. Another kid in Alabama, he bumped into somebody at a music festival, and they, was polite, apologized a whole bit. They get the posse to go after him, they're a little violent, rabidly evil posse, and they bash this kid's head in and put him in the hospital. Again, multiple opponents are all over the place. If you're a BJJ guy, under pressure, remember, we're not going to rise to the level of the challenge. We're coming down to a level of discipline. My C3 Tony Massengill is really fond of reminding us of that, of you're going to do what you're trained to do. Like Mike Tyson, everybody's a plan to get punched in the face. One of the things about pressure is it teaches us who we really are. All of us think we're pretty cool, and then the pressure hits us. And that could be personal life too. Our anger, the way we handle pressure, it says a lot about us, which is why martial artists are, we have this camaraderie here, all of us, because we're all submitting to discipline. And that's important. But in this case, if you're using BJJ, rather than boxing, you're not going to modify your BJJ for multiple opponents. You have to jettison it totally. It doesn't work in that scenario at all. If you do use it, it could get your head bashed in, get you killed. Whereas boxing, I might need to throw my jab higher or lower depending on where my opponent is. That's a modification. I can't modify my BJJ, my ground fighting, for multiple opponents. It doesn't work. That's what I'm saying. Can't use it for self-defense in modern America if there's more than one opponent, and that's not even getting into weaponry, right? But all of the evidence is that if we're in a self-defense scenario, it's very likely that you're going to see more than one person these days. That being said, you need a striking system that's mobile, okay, and it has anti-grappling, and you're able to create separation of space from you and your opponents, and you do not hit the ground. If you do hit the ground, you've trained to get yourself up without taking heavy shots, especially to the head. So you need a system. Now, clinch in fighting is important. And I would suggest that you do something kind of like a hybrid judo or Greco-Roman. Now, those arts, especially if you're able to throw people without you going to the ground yourself. And here's the thing about throwing for street fighting. And I'm hesitant to use the term street fighting. I keep trying to use self-defense. But you get my point, is that in any match, in any challenge between the earth and man throughout history, the earth is undefeated. And I think the best grappling technique of all time was a Hulk Loki smash. But I'm not strong enough to do that. Jack Reacher is. I was just watching parts of season two, man. That dude's jacked. So I digress. The grappling that you're thinking of and the grappling that you're being done in MMA or on, you know, BJJ tournaments is not consistent with that. It's not consistent with a multiple opponent scenario. So you got to make sure you, if you're training predominantly for self-defense, that you don't use that. Right? You can't use it. It's not good. You're going to be using a different skill set where you're mobile, you're keeping your eyes moving, you're able to cover and able to get the heck out of the way because there's shots coming at you from every direction. I'm very Dempsey-esque. I believe that the knockout is the biggest self-defense technique. If you can hit them hard and get them out of there, you win. And so I think being able to keep people in front of you, keep your feet moving, bang, and get people out of there, learn how to do a modified clinch game where you're hitting the body to drop them, right? Yeah. We say here all the time, everybody has a plan to get punched in the face. Well, everybody thinks they can take a body shot until you get hit with one. So learn how to hit the body too. That said, I'll say one more time, BJJ is a great discipline. I like boxing. I love boxing, as you can tell, but that's got to be modified for all-out fighting. People who trained with me back 20, 25, 30 years ago, it's been a long time now, know that we used to spar all the time. And I was sparring. That's what we did. We pretty much we would get together and we might spar for 10, 15 rounds a night. Each person, different groups sparring. That's what we did. But that ran into some problems when I realized that we become too sport oriented. So always soberly assess yourselves. Don't think more highly of your system than we ought to think. Think about it soberly because the reality, the rule of reality is what it is. And we're not going to change it. I don't care how enthusiastic I am. If I'm running east looking for a sunset, I got a serious problem. Life doesn't care what I'm feeling. It just cares what I'm doing. So that being said, BJJ for self-defense, not good in modern America. And I'm just warning people of the obvious, right? That's all. I'm not saying it doesn't work. I'm not saying it on a one-on-one. I think it's a fantastic system and it's great for discipline, for your competition. It does give you a great amount of skills. It definitely helps you if you haven't wrestled or didn't do BJJ. Because if you haven't wrestled, you don't understand what it's like to have somebody on you. You don't realize how much energy it takes, how fast things can happen, and you don't learn how to smother and that nature of thing. So it's a great discipline, but you have to see it in its realistic totality. If not, you could be a serious victim of that type of fight that we've been talking about. All right. That being said, hope you guys enjoyed the video. Okay. You can choke out or armbar that like and subscribe button and give us some love. Share the video, man. I mean, we love that. We're trying to get the message out so that what we're thinking about self-defense is true and realistic. Not like, this is what I think. This is what I think. I think this is good. Hopefully it works. Not a good idea. So again, thank you guys so much for watching and I will catch you guys next time. Have a happy new year.